Uganda ranks sixth among African countries with high malaria-related mortality rates, with 26 people dying in 1 week after infection with the disease, according to the health ministry, translating into a higher number of deaths monthly due to the disease. According to Dr. Jimmy Opigo, the commissioner in charge of malaria control division at the Ministry of Health, 40% of all hospital visits in Uganda are as a result of malaria, and this contributes to 10% of the deaths in the country.
The whole country, over 95%, is at risk, with limited exception of the highlands, that is Kigezi and Elgon area. Those places, because of being highlands, have low temperatures, are not favorable for mosquito proliferation. And as a result, we are the world's third most contributor of malaria cases after Nigeria and DRC, very populous countries. In terms of malaria deaths, we contribute the sixth to seventh most around the country, although around the world. In terms of visit to health facilities, 30 to 40% of all outpatient visits to any facility is a result of malaria. 20% of all people who are admitted in our facilities are there because of malaria, and up to 10% of deaths.
Dr. Opigo says malaria is a disease that affects mostly the poor. He lists some of the high-risk areas.
There are special interest groups who are disproportionately affected by malaria. One is children under 5. The other is pregnant mothers. The most affected region is Karamoja because of the nomadic lifestyle, housing, and level of development in that place. Malaria is a disease of poverty.
For many years now, the ministry has been promising Ugandans the malaria vaccine. The World Health Organization Uganda country representative, Dr. Jonas Woldemariam, says the malaria vaccine will be here early next year.
Uganda would receive and start vaccinating in 2024. If you ask me, I would have loved it to be here today, but due to supplies and program arrangements, we need to have it in 2024.
Dr. Woldemariam says Uganda is a model country to the rest of the world from the way it handled COVID-19 and Ebola in just 65 days. So WHO has faith that by 2030, malaria will be no more.
Uganda is one of the best examples on fighting epidemic diseases. It has a very good detection and addressing the issues. And probably, as you know, maybe it's one of the best in the African continent. But every time we try to learn from it and see how we can do it better, because what we want is that we have a gold standards.
As to what plans the World Health Organization has for Uganda in the next 1 to 5 years, he had this to say.
The priorities we are looking at is, for example, looking not only building Uganda's capacity in epidemic response or responses for communicable disease like tuberculosis, malaria, or HIV, but we are also emphasizing on non-communicable disease, be it diabetics, hypertension, and so forth.
News of a malaria vaccine comes at the right time. Uganda had set 2030 as the malaria-free year, but according to the Ministry of Health, the 1 million doses coming in next year will be for infants below 5 years and high-risk areas such as Karamoja. Report by John Musenze for the news.